ओके, वेलकम टू द ई लेक्चर सीरीज फॉर SCI सब्जेक्ट। एंड टुडे वी डिस्कस अबाउट एम्पिरिकल रिसर्च, मोर अबाउट द एम्पिरिकल रिसर्च एंड अदर कंसेप्ट्स रिलेटेड टू दिस एम्पिरिकल रिसर्च। सो इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी इंट्रोड्यूस द डिफरेंट कंसेप्ट ऑफ एम्पिरिकल रिसर्च, विच इज ऑब्जर्वेशन बेस्ड इन्वेस्टिगेशंस। And with reference to SCI, it refers to investigation about the usability of a system with end users. And the investigation is based on testable research questions. Important part of this empirical research. And we formulate, we see the formulate appropriate questions, how to make the questions. For the validity of the question and trade-off, and how to resolve the trade-offs, and also discuss the process of observation and measurement for getting the better outcome. And here in this lecture we shall learn about the other aspects of empirical research, and particularly we shall learn about the design of experiments using empirical research methods. So themes of empirical research, the three themes of empirical research: first, answer and raise questions like testable research questions, and second, observe and measure. Ratio scale of measurement is preferable, okay. And the third one is user studies. So already we have discussed first two themes, okay, and the third theme is user studies, and is equally important since we already know the observation is important in such studies. So user study, so as per the SCI, user study is a scientific way of collecting and analyzing observational data from end users on an interactive system, and it is the collection of data involving experiments and design of experiments. So it is a broader, or you can say next steps towards the empirical research. And experiment design, experiment it is a general term referring to the organization of variables, procedures, and other you can say concepts related to organizations, okay, and also related to systems, and in an experiment way, okay. And the process of designing an experiment is the process of designing on which variables to use, what produce to use, and how many participants to use, how to solicit them on different systems, okay. So as per the experiment design, there are different terminologies we have to know. So first is participants, okay, then second independent variables, test conditions, okay, then third dependent variables, okay, then fourth one is control variables. So participants, as you know, those are interact with the experiment, okay, and then independent variables based on the testable questions and test conditions, okay. Then dependent variables, which are actually dependent on the condition of the experiment, okay. And control variables, which controls the flow of the experiment, okay. So another different terminologies here, like random variables, okay, related to variables. First random variables, then second confounding variables, third within subjects versus between subjects, and fourth one is counterbalancing and Latin square. So we will see all this here. So participant first, people participating in an experiment are referred to as participants, and mostly when referring specifically to the experiment, use the term participants, okay. We can also use the user, but mostly it is termed as participants, okay, and general comments on the problem or conclusion drawn from the results may use other terms, okay. So next is independent variable. An independent variable is a variable that is selected or controlled through the design of the experiment, okay. And example includes like device, feedback mode, button layout, visual layout, gender, age, expertise, etc. And the term independent variables and factors are synonyms, okay. Then test conditions, the label values or setting for an independent variables are the test conditions, okay. And provide names for both on both an independent variable and the test condition for the control variable also, okay. So here are some examples. So factors like device and the labels related to device or test conditions like mouse, trackball, joystick, okay. So it is related with device only. Then feedback mode based on audio, tactile and visual, okay. Then for task related to pointing and dragging, okay. Then visualization 2D, 3D and animated. Then next is dependent variable, a variable representing the measurement or observation on an independent variable, okay. And it is required to provide a name for both the dependent variable and its units, like example here task completion time in MS, speed word per minute, selection per minute, okay, and error rate percentage and throughput bits per second. Then control variables, here control variables influences the dependent variables, okay. So factors that might influence a dependent variable but are not under investigation need to be accommodated in some manner, okay, to control the experiment. And one way is to control them or to treat them as control variables, like here example room lighting and background noise, temperature, okay. So various conditions or various environments also depends on the control variable, okay. And then random variables, instead of controlling all circumstances or factors, some might be allowed to vary randomly, okay. And such circumstances are random variables. Then confounding variable, any variable that varies systematically with an independent variable is a confounding variable. And for example, if three devices are always administered in the same order, participants' performance might improve due to practice, or from, you can see here, from the first to the second and to the third condition, like ranking wise condition, okay. And thus practice is a confounding variable, okay, because it varies systematically, okay, in a rank or a, you can say in a sequence with device, okay. And within subject and between subject, the administering of levels, administering of levels of a factor is either within subject or between subjects, okay. If each participant is tested on each level, the factor is within subject, and if each participant is tested on only one level, the factor is between subjects. So in this case, a separate group of participants is used for each level, okay. So you can see here within subject there are tested all the levels on each participants, and in case of between subject, different levels are used for different participants, okay. Then the term repeated measures and within subjects are synonyms, okay. And a relevant question is which of the two approaches, like within subject and between subjects, should be chosen in designing an experiment, okay. And also answers, or you can say results, depends, like sometimes a factor must be between subject, like gender, range, age, and sometimes a factor must be within subjects, like session or block, and sometimes there is a choice. In this case, there is a trade-off, okay. And also the advantage of the within subjects design is the variance due to participants predispositions should be the same across test conditions. And also for the between subject design has the advantage of avoiding interference effects like the practice effects while typing on two different layouts of keyboards. Okay. And the next is counterbalancing. Okay, so counterbalancing for repeated measures design, participants' performance may tend to improve with practice as they progress from one level to the next. So the participants may perform better on the second level simply because they benefited from practice on the first one. Okay, and this is undesirable for the experiment, and to compensate, the order of presenting condition is counterbalanced. Then last year Latin Square, the participants are divided into groups and a different order of administrations is used for each group for experiment, and the order is best governed by a Latin Square. Okay, and here the you can say defining the characteristics of a Latin Square is that each condition occur only once in each row and column. Okay, so here is the Latin Square. You can see the example. Suppose we want to administer four levels denoted by ABCD of a factor to four participants represented by P1, P2, P3 and P4. Okay, and we can construct a 4x4 Latin Square arrangement to depict the order of administrating the level of each participants for performing experiments according to participants and different levels. Okay, and then in balanced Latin Square, each condition both precedes and follow each other condition an equal number of times according to the matrix. Okay, balanced matrix. So we can construct a balanced 4x4 Latin Square arrangement for the previous example. And expressing the experiment design here, consider the statement like 3x2 repeated measures designs. So it refers an experiment with two factors having three levels on the first and two levels on the second. Okay, again I repeat, 3x2 repeated measured designs, and it refers an experiment with two factors having three levels on the first and two levels on the second. And there are six test conditions in total. Okay, and both factors are repeated measures, meaning all participants were tested on all test conditions, and any type of experiment is expressed similarly. Okay, so that's all about the empirical research concepts. Okay, after this we will study more about some details or practices used in empirical research. So that's all for this topic. Thank you.